Students, we continue with question 10. So in question 10, you have got a manufacturer sells the TV to a distributor at rupees 51,200, but that is including tax, that includes the GST. So let the price without GST be X. So X plus 28% is the GST rate. So X plus 28% of X is 51,200. So in this case, they had not given the price without GST. They gave you a price with GST. So first, you have to find this X. That is, what is the price without GST? So the manufacturer's sale price or the distributor's cost price excluding GST is rupees 40,000. Because I have told you many times, I have told you in this lecture, in the previous video also, that you never pocket the GST, so you have to find CP and SPS without GST. So that is without GST, and you find the profit made by the manufacturer or distributor or retailer, anyone. All the profit is without GST, because GST goes to the government. So cost price of TV excluding GST for the distributor is rupees 40,000. So now it is given that the distributor sells it to a retailer at 43,000. So that is excluding tax. It's clearly given. 43,000 excluding tax. So SP of distributor or CP of retailer excluding GST is 43,000. So from these two equations that you have written, you know CP and SP. That is, CP of distributor is 40 and SP of distributor is 43,000. So from that you get the profit. Distributor's profit is rupees 3,000. So the first answer was cost price of the distributor. Of course, that means without GST, because they have already given you the price with GST, so you were supposed to find the price without GST. And second thing that they have asked is GST paid by distributor to government. So to find that, we found the profit. Now on this profit, 28% would be the GST paid by distributor to government. So 28% of 3,000, that is rupees 840. That is the second answer. That's the GST paid by distributor to the government. Total GST received by government from the sale of the TV. So you have to find what is the price paid by the customer, or what is the sale price of retailer or cost price of customer. On that price, 28% would be the total GST received by the government. I will not again and again go back to that chart, because you learn the sums as per sums. The chart which I drew was only for your understanding what is happening in these transactions. So now here, retailer's SP or customer's CP without GST is rupees 45,000. So now on this 45,000 rupees, if you and I go to the shop to buy this television, we have to pay 28% on this 45,000. Because for us it is not the profit on which we are going to pay, because we are not selling it to someone. So on 45,000, 28%, that is rupees 12,600, will be the total GST paid by the customer, and that will be the GST received by government. And that GST received by government, you can also say, or total GST paid by customer. Total GST paid by the end customer. So that is the GST paid by the customer, and that's answer 3. That's the GST that the government got. Now, price paid by customer would be retailer sale price, that is 45,000, plus the total GST that has been charged. So the customer will have to bear the bill of 57,600 rupees. So this GST customer is paying, and this is retailer sale price, that also. This goes to the retailer's pocket, and this will go to the government. So total 57,600 rupees is paid. So So now the 11th sum is slightly different. In this sum, they are telling you how much GST was paid by the shopkeeper to the government. It is given that GST paid by shopkeeper to government is rupees 72. So GST is paid on the profit. 12% of the profit is what is the GST paid by the shopkeeper to the government. So from that you can find what is the profit. The profit made by the shopkeeper will be rupees 600. So SP of shopkeeper is the mark price. It is given that the shopkeeper is selling it to the customer at the mark price, which is rupees 4500. And from this you computed the profit is rupees 600. That means CP of shopkeeper. When you say CP of shopkeeper, it is always excluding GST. All this is excluding GST. This is 4500, that is the SP minus profit, so 3900 rupees. The SP of the shopkeeper again is excluding GST. All this is excluding GST, because I told you GST cannot be included in the CP and SP, because the GST doesn't go to the shopkeeper's pocket, it goes to the government. The shopkeeper is only collecting it from the customer and giving it to the government. So here, CP of shopkeeper is 3900, SP of shopkeeper is 4500, and that is because you had found the profit was rupees 600. So now price paid by shopkeeper including GST. So what is the price at which the shopkeeper bought it? Cost price of shopkeeper was 3900. But that didn't include the GST. So now including GST means 12% of 3900 is the GST that he pays. So he has to pay 3900 plus 468, that is rupees 4368, that is price paid by shopkeeper including GST. Now the second point, they have asked you how much was the discount that the shopkeeper got. Shopkeeper would have brought it from the distributor. So how much discount the shopkeeper got when he brought it? You know what is the CP and what is the SP. SP was the mark price, that is 4500, and CP was 3900. So the profit made by the, or the discount that the shopkeeper got was rupees 600. So shopkeeper's cost price was 3900 and his sale price was 4500. So the discount what he got was rupees 600. So on that discount is on what price? On the mark price. So 600 rupees upon 4500, that is discount upon the mark price into 100, 13.33% is the percentage discount that the shopkeeper got, maybe from the distributor, on the mark price. So this is a typical different type of sum. So mark the sum important, because if you don't practice this, you will be clueless in the first step itself. When you get this 72 rupees he paid, I don't know how to do this sum. If you do not know how to find the profit, you have to find the profit first, and then from the profit you know what is the SP of shopkeeper. It is the mark price itself. So from that you can find what is the cost price. 4500 minus the profit will give you the cost price. Once you get this, then the sum is very easy. Then it is the normal sum. But to remember this, you have to practice it. So mark it important and write it down and practice it also. All the classwork sums which are taught in GST. GST has different types of sums, just like you had straight lines. Different types and different methods. So there are some chapters in which those sums you have to repeatedly practice. Now for example, if you have OJF, only one type of OJF. So once you know the method, if you avoid making any addition mistakes for finding the points to plot, then that is very easy. So those are extremely simple sums. Banking, one formula and two types of sums. So that is very easy. But these chapters like GST, then you have chapters like straight lines, there you have to spend more time and do more practice. So copy this sum, we go on to the 12th sum. So in this question, it's very similar to the previous question, identical sum, just the values have changed. You are given the mark price of an article is rupees 30,000 and there is a GST of 18%. Now, sale price of shopkeeper to customer will be the mark price. That is also mentioned. It is the same rupees 30,000. So, GST paid by shopkeeper means GST paid by shopkeeper to government. It is given like in the previous one. It is given 1080 is the GST paid by the shopkeeper to the government. So, he will pay 18% of the profit as GST. So from this you can find what is the profit paid by the shopkeeper, made by the shopkeeper. So 1080 into 100 upon 18, that is rupees 6000 is the profit. So profit is 6000, the sale price was 30,000. So you can find the shopkeeper's cost price excluding GST. That is this 30,000 sale price minus profit will give you the cost price. So this is the cost price, and the price paid by the shopkeeper will not only be this, this was excluding GST, but on top of this the invoice will also mention 18% of 24,000, that is 4320. So the total price paid by the shopkeeper including GST is rupees 28,320. So that is the total price paid by the shopkeeper including GST. Now how much discount the shopkeeper got, we know that is actually equal to the profit itself, that is SP minus CP. So the discount the shopkeeper got, he sold it at 30,000 and he had brought it at 24,000. So he got a discount of 6,000 rupees on the mark price of the article. So percentage discount is 6,000 on 30,000. So that is 20% discount the shopkeeper got. So now they have asked you what is the price paid by the customer. So without GST, the price paid by the customer is equal to the sale price of shopkeeper. This price, sale price of shopkeeper or the mark price, that is the price paid by the customer without GST. So of course 18% on that 30,000 is GST. So 5,400 rupees is the GST. So 35,400 rupees is the total GST, including GST, the total price paid by the customer. So write it down. This is, as I told you in the last sum, a different type of sum. So if it is asked in the unit test, you should know the first part. Otherwise, you will not be able to proceed with it. See, this is extremely simple sum. There is a dealer in Agra. He is selling it to a dealer in Jhansi. And he is selling it for 1,000 rupees. The Jhansi person is making profit and he is selling it to a dealer in Mumbai at rupees 1,600. So now the question asks this, what is the input tax for the dealer in Jhansi? So the input for dealer in Jhansi is this rupees 1,000. So on 1,000 he has to pay 12% or 120 rupees tax. So that tax which Jhansi person has to pay Agra person, that is known as input tax. So on the 1,000 rupees he is paying 12% or 120 rupees, that is the input GST paid by Jhansi dealer. Now what is the output of Jhansi dealer? It is 1,600. So when he sells it to the Mumbai dealer, he will charge 1,600 plus 12% GST. So the output tax for Jhansi dealer is 12% of 1,600, that is 192 rupee, that is his output tax. That's the second answer which is asked. So now next question asks is how much he will pay the government. This Jhansi person has to pay the government. He will pay the government what is his output tax minus his input tax. The difference, 192 minus 120, that is 72. This you could also have calculated on the basis of his profit. His profit is 600 rupees. So on 600 rupees, 12% will come to same 72 rupees. Or the easy way here, because you found this and this, this minus the 2, that will give you the net GST payable by Jhansi dealer to government. Now, what is the CP for Mumbai dealer? They have asked you total CP, which means they expect you to add the GST. So, in such cases, make it very clear, write both. CP for Mumbai dealer without GST is 1600 rupees, because he sold it at 1600, plus 12% of 1600, which you have already calculated, 192, is the GST. So, CP of Mumbai dealer with GST, total price paid by Mumbai. Actually, you don't call it CP, you call it total price paid by Mumbai dealer. So, this is 1792. Usually, when you say CP, it does not include the GST. So, here, what they mean in the question, total CP is including GST. So, you write both, without GST and with GST, so that it's very clear. So, we go on to the 14th sum. 14th sum, read the question carefully. A dealer A in Bihar buys an article for rupees 5000 from dealer B in Punjab. So dealer A is not the first person, it's the second person. Punjab dealer B is the first person. He is selling it to dealer A, who is in Bihar. So usually you write A first, B second, so don't do that. Here it is B selling to A at rupees 5000. And then that dealer in Bihar is selling it to another dealer in Bihar itself at rupees 6000. So now whether it is Bihar, UP, wherever it is, that doesn't really matter. Because in your sum you are asked, what is the GST paid? See, actually when you have interstate sale, like you are sitting in Mumbai and ordering something from Delhi, so it's an intercity sale, so it is called IGST. I had told you in the start. IGST is when there is intercity movement. So from one state to another, if it is not in the same state, then it is called IGST. But if the sale is in, let's say, Maharashtra, Maharashtra only, Mumbai product is being sold in Pune, then that is known as GST, and 50% of that is state GST and 50% of that is central government GST. So, but you are not required to bother about all these details of SGST, CGST and all that, unless and until a question is there in which it is told that the GST paid by the customer to the state is so much. So then you have to understand that you have to double that to get the total GST. If it's GST paid to the state is 200 rupees, that means the total GST is 400 rupees because equal amount is paid. But here you don't have to bother about whether it is interstate or same state, all that. So now here they have asked you the price including GST paid by dealer A. You can get a simpler sum, 5000 plus 18%, so 5900 rupees. And the next they have asked you the price including GST paid by dealer C. So 6000 plus 18%, so 6000 plus 1080, that is rupees 7080. That was a very simple sum. Now in the 15th sum, make a correction in the question. So in this there is a correction in the question, please note it down. In the question it was given a shopkeeper sells an article for rupees 1770 with GST of 18%, it should be excluding the GST. This price 1770 does not include the GST. So he would have sold it at 1770 plus 18%. So the person would have roughly paid much more than that. So now the shopkeeper is originally planning to sell it at 1770 plus that much rupees GST. But the customer now comes to his shop and tells him that I have only this much money and I will pay you only 1888. That is the maximum I can pay for this. So now, shopkeeper can't put the sale price as 1770. He has to give him a discount. And on the discounted price, once he charges GST, the total price paid by the customer will be 88. So let's assume that the price without GST at which the shopkeeper has reduced price at which he is going to sell it is X. So X plus 18% of X should be 1888. So that means 118X upon 100 into X, this after taking the LCM, is 1888. So we get X as rupees 1600. So this X would be the 1600 would be the reduced sale price without GST, and on this 288 rupees would be the GST that is charged. If you take 18% of 1600, it will be 288. So 1600 plus 288 would be 1888. So we are not asked how much is the GST, we are asked what is the reduced price at which the shopkeeper will sell the article. So how much reduction is required? So the original price was 1770, the mark price at which the shopkeeper was supposed to sell it to the customer and then charge GST. But now the reduced price is 1600. So 1770 minus 1600, that means 170 rupees reduction has to be made in the price. Market sum is important because this again is a different type of sum. Now if you don't practice this, then you wouldn't be able to probably think of the reduction, how to find the reduction. It's a very simple sum, but since it's a different type of sum, market is important. With that, we have fully completed GST. Now when we do the Zoom class, we will do some of the homework sums in the Zoom session. So after that, you can try the remaining homework sums which we have not tried in Zoom. So okay students, practice this. Bye.